We can't let Goldie take over Oridon. We need to call Scrooge and tell him to come back. We can't. They left their phones behind. Well, we gotta do something. Should we face those villains ourselves? No, wait, I've got a better idea. I can make a spell to send them back to where they came from, maybe even further away than that. Yeah, there's nothing more powerful than the power of friendship after all. Everyone hold hands. The strength of evil is good as none when stands before six hearts as one. Heroes always come out on top. Bring the villain's reign to a stop. Did it work? Doesn't look like it. But it should have worked. Why didn't it work? Why didn't what work? And why are we holding hands?
Maybe you didn't say it loud enough?
No. The spell needs all six of us to work. And Branch doesn't remember anything, including the fact that we're his friends. Without Branch, the spell won't work.
Oh, this is bad. We should gather everyone up and build an army and take those villains on.
I don't know. There may not be very many people who can help. Who knows how many people have been glued to the ground or had their memories erased?
What are we gonna do?
I think there's only one thing we can do. We need to get to the island where Scrooge and his family is, and get them back here before it's too late. We don't even know where they're at. They took the only vacation brochure with them. All we know is they're on an island with a volcano that's not supposed to erupt anymore. Maybe my mom can find out where they are.
So, you're saying I'm your boyfriend?
Yes. We've been dating for a year, and you were gonna propose to me down at the shore, but then Ivy appeared and erased your memory.
And who's Ivy?
How many times I gotta tell ya? Okay, it appears my cauldron can't locate exactly where they're at, but it does know one thing about the island they're on.
What's that?
The volcano on that island will erupt this Friday.
What?
But Scrooge said he doesn't know how wrong he is.
But we can get them back way before Friday, right?
If we leave now, we should be able to. Branch, go tell Launchpad to start the plane.
Plane? Are we going somewhere?
Morgana, please tell me you have a spell that can return Branch's memory.
I have lots of spells.
Great!
A memory restoration spell isn't one of them. I'm afraid there's nothing I can do to help Branch.
No, please. Can't you create a spell or a potion?
Well, there is a potion that can be made, but there's one ingredient, a bright blue flower called Minne, that cannot be found here in Oridon. Without it, I'm afraid Branch is helpless.
We need to leave. The sooner, the better.
I don't think I should come.
What?
But why? I need to stay here and keep everyone safe as best I can. And maybe I can find a way to keep Goldie distracted till Scrooge gets back.
Maybe I can help.
Dewey?
You want to help?
I know you don't trust me, and I don't blame you, but Oridon is my home. Someone has to protect it.
How do we know you won't try to take over the kingdom again?
Look, I messed up, big time, but I've realized just how precious my family is. I should have seen that a long time ago. So just give me a chance to prove I can change.
Fine, but I'm gonna keep my eye on you. Branch should stay too. If he can't remember a thing, he's not gonna be much help.
Well, we need someone to take his place. Who knows if there's danger on the island?
We need someone brave,
someone tough,
someone fierce.
Kion.
What are we waiting for?
Let's go.
Okay, where am I going?
I guess just look for an island with a volcano on it.
Island with volcano, got it.
Okay, Dewey, you want to help? Start by getting Poppy and Branch out of here and somewhere safe. Tell everyone you see to stay indoors until further notice.
Yes, Violet.
Better get going. Looks like the villains are on their way to the castle.
Come on, you two.
Oh, Violet! Come and meet your extended family.
Family, this is my daughter, Violet.
So, you're Violet?
What a serendipity doodah!
Hi, Violet. So nice to finally meet you. My name's Move Over, Wendy. Nobody likes an in-your-face freak like you. Ha! And she sticks the landing, like always. Don't worry, I can't stand her either.
Hey, break it up.
Nice to meet you, family. What brings you to Auradon? Like you don't know, there's gonna be a new queen in Auradon.
Really? Whoever could it be?
Don't answer that.
Hilarious.
Seriously though, your mother is gonna be a queen that Auradon will never forget. The Queen of Mean.
Ooh, that has a nice ring to it.
Good name, glad I thought of it. Please, you as queen, you and what army?
Me and this army? Duh!
Business? Ivy? Start getting the throne room ready. My coronation starts at sunset.
Not so fast. We won't let you take over this kingdom without a fight.
Before you crown yourself queen, I declare a challenge.
A challenge?
Violet and I against your family? If we win, Auradon will stay under the rule of the rightful ruler, King Huey Duck. If you win, all of Auradon will be yours, and everyone will be your slaves. Forever.
Make it 3 challenges, and let my family decide the challenges.
Very well.
Challenge accepted.
3 challenges it will be. We will start with an easy challenge tomorrow.
Then the next day, we will have the medium challenge. Then the hard challenge will happen the day after that.
Whoever wins the most challenges will be declared the ruler of Auradon on Friday.
Now everyone get some rest. We begin first thing in the morning.
A challenge? I was trying to buy the others time to find Scrooge. Surely they'll be back before the challenges are over.
I hope they find him soon.
Maybe we better try and cross the street, huh? Skip the gutter. Maybe I should train this in. Something is definitely wrong. I'm right, it's wrong.
There's no one out there. They must be at the castle. We're safe. For now.
Hey, are you okay? My boyfriend doesn't remember who I am anymore. Now I'll never get to marry him. Oh, Branch, if only I knew you were gonna propose to me, you wouldn't be in this mess.
Hey, Poppy, don't be so hard on yourself. It's not your fault.
But what if that moment at the shore was the last moment we would ever have together?
What if that's the last time we ever talked. Why didn't I say yes?
When I let him walk away, what if I had spoken instead? Why did I go on concealing the confusion I was feeling? Now I'll never get to say all the things I should have said. Now there's no more love, just echoes of the life we should have led. If I could take that moment back, if he were here beside me still, I'd let him see inside my
The next day.
Is the first challenge ready?
Yep, we're just missing one thing. Oh, Violet! Step aside, Burger Man. Let the pro show you how it's done. Violet! Is it morning already? I was dreaming I was kissing Huey. What was that? I said missing Huey. I miss him 'cause he's on vacation. I certainly didn't say kissing. Now, where were we? Ah, yes. The first challenge is about to begin in the dining room. Come.
Should I change out of my pajamas first, or-
I said come!
They say breakfast is the most important meal of the day. For the first challenge, we shall see who can eat all their breakfast. And what better breakfast meal than my favorite, the spiciest spices in the world?
That's cobra zest, demon pepper, la muerte instantánea, the instant death.
This is what you call an easy challenge. It was the easiest challenge we could come up with. Violet versus Pete. Whoever finishes their spices first wins. And no one is allowed to drink this glass of water. If either of you even starts to reach for this nice, refreshing, cold glass of aqua purificada, you lose. Ready? The challenge begins in 3, 2, 1. Begin! And we have a winner? Violet wins. Impressive, but there's still two challenges left, and it's only gonna get harder from here. So go and celebrate your victory. You won't be celebrating for long. Yeah, you did it. You just gulped down those spices. Oh man, I'm still geeking out about it. If you were able to do something that hard so easily, we should definitely have this victory in the bag. How did you eat all those spices anyway? When the things you treasure are in danger, you kind of find the guts to do the impossible.
Also, my mouth is on fire. Excuse me.
Meanwhile.
What just happened?
The plane broke down and crashed into the ocean. Then I passed out, and when I woke up, we were on this island shore.
An island? Maybe we floated back up to the surface.
That's impossible. The plane's too heavy. We obviously would sink down into the ocean.
Then how are we on an island shore? Guys, take a look at this. A volcano? Could this be where Scrooge is? Only one way to find out. Let's take a look around.
Look! Duck footprints! It's gotta be Scrooge. Scrooge! Scrooge! You're not Scrooge. Scrooge! He's clear on the other side of this island. Scrooge is here?
The other side of the island? This island is huge and long, and he's clear on the other side of the island?
The farther the better.
Okay, we better find him then. Come on.
Thanks, Donald.
Wait, you know that duck?
Oh, I'll explain later. Right now we should find Scrooge.
The next day.
Oh yes, Huey. Do give me 5 more minutes.
Of course. Anything for you?
Kiss me again, Huey.
Oh, Violet. Did I mention I think you're beautiful?
Why, as a matter of fact...
Shh.
Hold that thought.
I have to ask you something. Will you marry me? Will you be my queen?
Yes. Yes.
What? What just happened?
Gosh, I hope we were recording that.
As a matter of fact, I filmed the whole thing.
You're welcome.
What's going on? Where's Huey? He just asked you to marry him? That was all me. I'm an expert at impersonations.
Will you marry me? Will you be my queen?
And then you said,
yes, yes.
Okay, Webby, I'll admit, this was pretty funny. Hilarious, in fact. When will you learn that all my pranks are hilarious?
Get dressed. Your second challenge begins in 30 minutes.